In this three-part series, I will review my CPF account balances and discuss my CPF strategies so you can help you fund your long-term retirement plan. And today, I'm going to talk about the CPF special account and how you can make it work better. Do check out my other earlier videos on my ordinary account and my MediSave account on this playlist. What's up guys, welcome back to Honey Money SG. My name is Christopher and in this channel, we are all about building financial knowledge, teach money saving hacks and also help you lead a fulfilling quality of life. Today, we are going to talk about the special account. So here are some usages of the special account, which is not much. Because the primary purpose of this special account is to save for your retirement funds. If you want to invest, you can only use your SA to invest in the CPF SA approved investment schemes and make sure you can earn more than 4 or 5% investment returns to make your effort worthwhile, which judging by the list of things that I can invest on, I'm not very confident that I can achieve more than 4 or 5%. Okay, and then some basic facts. The CPF SA earns you 4% annual interest, which is rather high. For age 35 and below, you'll get a 6% allocation into your CPF SA. So what that means is that if you earn a $3,000 gross salary, $180 of it will go into the CPF SA. And also remember that the combined balances of $60,000 in your CPF account would earn an additional 1% interest if you're aged 55 and below. And if you're above the age of 55, you earn 2% on your first 30k combined balances and 1% on your next $30,000 CPF balances. So if I were you, I will make sure my CPF SA and MA are combined up to $60,000 because the OA has a cap of $20,000 that earns that additional 1% interest. Okay, now let's go on to the topic of how to build your CPF SA to reach the full retirement sum faster. So what is the full retirement sum? This is basically the limit set for the full retirement, which is $186,000 in the year of 2021. So if you want to top up or transfer from your OA to your SA, the limit that you can do so is only up to the limit of $186,000 this year, which also means that if you have $186,000, the Singapore government deems that you have enough resources to retire, which is why it's called the full retirement sum. Anyway, let's take a look at how we can use some strategies to beef up your CPF SA balance. Number one is the CPF retirement sum top up, or RSTU. So you can top up to $7,000 per year, known as the RSTU, to your SA, and this will help you gain tax relief. How it works that if you top up $7,000 via RSTU to your SA, it will deduct $7,000 from your tax assessable income, and depending on your income tax bracket, you will deduct a certain percentage of your income tax. So let's say if you top up $7,000 and your income tax bracket is at 7%, then it will save 7% of that $7,000, which is $490 of tax savings. Also, unlike the MA, it does not count into the voluntary contribution limit of $37,740, so you don't have to worry about contributing too much and getting no returns back. Anyway, if you want to learn more about CPF retirement sum top up, I did make an earlier video over here, do check out that link here. The next strategy is to do a OA to SA transfer. OA to SA transfer is very straightforward. Basically, you are transferring balances from your OA to your SA, and the reason is because a lot of people have actually big balances in their OA, and if they are not using it in the short term, then they may want to consider transferring it to the SA to earn a greater interest and reach the full retirement sum earlier. Of course, there's a limit of how much you can do that, and there is the prevailing full retirement sum, which is 186k for year 2021. Next up, let's take a look at CPF special account shielding, which has recently been a very popular topic. Now, before I talk about shielding, I want to talk about the situation that makes you want to do shielding. Upon the age of 55, your retirement account called the RA will be set up after your birthday. The RA will first take your retirement funds from the SA, because that is meant for retirement, and then followed by OA to build the retirement account. And how much will they take out depends on the prevailing FRS. So if you are 55 years old this year, they will take out $186,000 from your SA first. And then if you don't have enough money in your SA to make up the $186,000, CPF will then take it from the ordinary account. So then you must be thinking, why they don't take it from the ordinary account? Because the ordinary account has so low interest that at 2.5% versus versus the SA at 4%. Now the truth is, a lot of people rather keep their OA balances because they can be used for housing, investment, and education loan purposes as described in my earlier video. And then they think that the SA has no use. The truth is, the SA is very useful after you are age 55 and you have met the full retirement sum. Because the CPF rule is that you can only withdraw your amounts above the full retirement sum from your CPF. So once you have already built up your retirement account, you have sort of like an ATM that can allow you to withdraw funds whenever you need a huge chunk of money. And you want to keep this in a higher yielding account, which is the SA rather than the OA. And that's why the CPF shielding comes in, so that it can help you protect your SA funds. So the CPF shielding methodology is very simple. When your RA is set up, you want your RA to take funds from your OA instead of your SA. And in order to do that, you have to empty your SA. So how do you do that? So a few working days before your birthday, you want to use your SA funds to buy into the CPF investment schemes, such as the bond fund. So once you make this investment, CPF will withdraw your SA funds to fund this bond investment. And then now when your retirement account is set up on your birthday, they have nothing to take out from the SA, so they have to take out from the OA instead. And then after the retirement account has been fully funded, then you want to sell back your investment to put your money back into your SA. So now you have a fully funded retirement account, a full SA account, and a low OA account, which is what you want, right? Because the higher interest accounts are kept at the full amounts, while the lower interest OA account is kept at a minimum balance. Of course, there are some things to consider when you're doing this shielding hack. The first assumption is that your OA account balances have enough to cover the full retirement sum for the retirement account. That means having at least $186,000 in your OA if you are retiring this year at 55. And then the second thing to note here is you can only invest amounts above $40,000 in your SA. So that means $40,000 must still stay in your SA account for them to deduct for your retirement account. If this sounds very confusing, do leave your questions down in the comment section below and I try to help you answer them. So once all these have been settled with your CPF shielding, then you have two very high interest yield saving accounts in your special account and your retirement account, while your OA will continue generating 2.5 interest. And then as and when you want to withdraw, you can withdraw from your OA and your SA subsequently, because now you already have your retirement account set up. So any funds above the retirement sum can be fully withdrawn, except for the funds that are topped up via RSTU, because those funds are ring fenced and not allowed to be withdrawn. Anyway, here is my special account review, and you can see that it is actually quite high for my age. My target is to reach the full retirement account by the January of next year, 2022, after I have done the retirement sum top up. And I have achieved this mainly because I did a lot of OA to SA transfer, and also subsequently RSTU to help beef up the special account. Of course, that is with the assumption that I have no use for the OA in the short term. In terms of housing, I am able to cover it with my existing OA funds and the subsidy. And also, if that is not enough, I also have my OA investments to liquidate it. And I'm not asking you to follow my style, because everyone has different circumstances. For example, if you buy a more expensive flat, you will need to prepare more money to pay down your housing loan, and that is not a good time to do an OA to SA transfer because you do not have enough funds to pay your mortgage. Anyway, I'm quoting Mr. Lu from the 1M65 movement, which he said that if you have 130k in your special account by the age of 30, you can easily reach 1M65 as a couple. So that means $1 million in your CPF account as a couple, and that means 500k for each person. How that works is that your 130k at age 30, when compounded for 35 years at the interest rate of 4%, will grow to more than 500k when you reach the age of 65. So that's what the 1M65 movement is about, and I've already achieved it at age 30. Anyway, this content is not meant to be flex or brag, but more of sharing that if a normal salary employee like me can do it, I think a lot of you can achieve it as well. Of course, different people have different circumstances, and there are a lot of CPF haters out there that must be scolding me right now. Why are you so stupid to top up to CPF? Why you go and transfer? I must say, different strokes for different folks. So go with the strategy that you are most comfortable with. Anyway, this applies the same to all investment styles. CPF is meant to be a safety net and not a get rich quick scheme. So once you have secured this safety net, it can allow you to take on more risks, such as business investments or even cryptocurrency and NFTs. Which is why before you take on risks for more investments, you have to build a safety net to make sure that your retirement plan is not affected. And that's where I'm coming from. Alright, that's about it guys on my sharing of the CPF special account, and I hope that you have learned something out of it. If you find this useful, do share it to your friends and family to help them add their knowledge, and also subscribe to this channel if you haven't so they can learn more about financial knowledge videos like this. Do check out my other videos over here and subscribe if you haven't. My name is Christopher, this is Honey Money SG, steering young adults to financial independence.